This might be the last time. Say goodbye. This might be the last.
When I began my freshman year at Denison, I came as an ambivalent yet energetic wee little lamb, naively ready for anything life might throw in my path without a single clue as to how I would handle it. However, my life suddenly became gloomy one day when I happened to receive my first email from a mysterious entity known only to the campus as Cookie Sunkle. Now, at first, I thought nothing of such a unique name until the emails began to relentlessly bombard my inbox. At first, they came only once or twice a week, but soon, it grew to multiple times per day, and usually at the most awkward of times. Like, the problem exacerbated so quickly that by fall study break, I usually received an average of 3 emails per hour. Eventually, I just flat out blocked the address, and for a time, I had peace. But then, things got weird.
Yeah, hold on. Hello?
And that's about the time I decided I should ask my wizened upperclassmen friends if they had ever found out just who is Cookie Sunkle.
Cookie Sunkle? Where did you hear that name?
There's that charity fight she had against DMX. Oh man, that was so cool.
Cookie Sunkle is flawless.
One time, I saw Cookie Sunkle wearing army pants and flip-flops, so I bought army pants and flip-flops.
My day's just not complete until I get that email from Cookie Sunkle. There it is!
Who's your uncle?
So, no help there, and things were getting quite worse. Torturous harassment has to stop. I've got to get to the bottom of this.
Oh, Cookie's uncle? Yeah, he's a nice guy.
I hear she does car commercials in Japan.
One time, she punched me in the face. It was awesome.
Cookie's uncle sends an email. Another email. Thousands of emails.
Gold in her chowder.
I heard she once taught baby otters how to read. They're like scholars now.
Is that it? Is that all everybody knows? Or are they just playing me for some kind of fool? I can't take it anymore. Seriously though, what's with all the cookies? They must be playing me. It has to be. There's no way. I can't handle. It's everywhere. It's everything.
Running mountains, reverse guide, better living.
Congratulations on your new baby. It really is a beautiful little girl. I'm almost finished with all the paperwork. I'm just going to need a name to put on the birth certificate.
Well, we really like the name Kayla. And Christine is nice, too.
We're not naming our daughter Christine.
Right, but of course, we decided on Kayla. Kayla Kumaroff. What a beautiful name.
I'm sorry, that username is already taken.
Or a man in her fascinating voice. How can I get through this laser security grid system if I can't even see the room on the bed? Do you expect me to talk? No, Miss Madison. I expect you to read from this piece of paper. I am a genius. Everyone, take 10. We'll be back.
Everything about it is appealing. Everything the traffic will allow. Nowhere could you get that happy feeling.
Hello, I'm here to... illnesses in general, mumps, measles. Okay, wait, all right. Hi.
Hello.
My name is Sam.
I'm Charlotte, and this hunk of Rami is Charlie.
Oh, don't listen to her. She's the sexy one.
Babe! I'm undecided on my major. Right now, I'm thinking of majoring in chemistry.
Hi, my name is Dak. Tell me about yourself.
My name's Dak. I'm a theater major with a dance minor. I'm from New Mexico. In terms of other stuff, I like, you know, pizza, Netflix, video games, you know.
Listen, you seem great. Can I get your number?
Today we'll be trying out some different herbs and mixtures that Samantha brought in for tea. tea time today. So, what do you have for us today, Samantha?
Well, I'm very excited for today, Terry. Today I brought with me some herbal teas.
Yes.
We have your classics, such as this black tea from Vietnam, and this mint tea. But my favorite kind of tea, Terry, is the chamomile.
I'm crying because I'm not sure if you can smell this, listeners, but the aroma is very satisfying. Systematically oppresses men, women, trans, and those those who identify of no gender or any gender. Now, we can't allow people who oppress another group of people to continue to oppress those people. For it's not the American way. It's American freedom. And freedom is what America stands for. For if we allow another group of people to oppress people, then we cannot.
Stare out, Kevin!
No, that's it!
I'm here to arrest you for hijacking the National Public Radio and using it to voice treason all of America.
What will happen if you catch me?
It's a crime punishable by... deductions on your refundable tax form and $250 fine.
You'll never take me alive!
Listeners, I'm in the studio. You're trying to execute me as we speak. Don't let the truth be silenced, America. Don't let my voice die, America.
Carol, please. Amazing Grace.
And so America was saved by its second greatest hero from its greatest threat, the National Public Radio.
Heard. I wish I had a better voice and sang some better words. I wish I found some chords in an order that is new. I wish I didn't have to rhyme every time I sang. I was...
Doc, what do you think?
I'm really not sure where to begin with this. This Stanford Prism Experiment Venezuela edition, as we call it, has several serious issues I would like you to explain to me. Yeah. It says here you plan on acquiring participants through bogus internship offers. Now,
isn't that illegal? Not under Governor Walker, it isn't. I assure you, this methodology is far sounder than the one in my previous experiment.
Ah, yes,
My nationality just changed.
Beneficial brainwashing experiment.
Yes, I used ramen and trap doors.
Ah, quite right. What exactly do you mean here? Participants will be subjected to routine torture by McDonald's.
Oh, there are just so many options on that.
Such as?
Well, for example, sometimes on guards put pudding in meals. Except all of the puddings will be licorice flavored.
Oh, dear.
Sometimes I'll tell them that I'm letting them go, walk them to the door, but the fun part is I reuse the trap door from the first experiment. Also,
why are you speaking in, how do you say, le present tense?
Well, I'm actually taking over here doing a little bit of a test run. I've had someone kept for about 2 months now, and I have to say it's going quite swimming.
Hold on. You have been keeping a man prisoner for 2 months?
Yes. His name is George. He's actually in the back. Go on, go get him, friend. Go. Pass it.
You've got to help me! This mad woman and her goons have kept me in the basement for weeks! The smell is terrible and the Wi-Fi is garbage.
Quentin Eric Ackman! This is the last straw. I do not know what has come over you, but you will release this young man immediately. Or I will call the police. Do not worry, ma chérie. I assure you, the university system will adequately compensate you for your...
Oh, sweet savior.
Well, I guess the great science have come to an end.
It would appear if I were a real scientist, and not your brother, Henri.
What?
Sorry.
Oh, humanity.
I'm glad this happened.
What was that?
This, you goof. I'm glad that you finally worked up the courage to ask
me. Honey, me too. Ask for romantically at all.
Yes, I only wish I could see you. Being completely blind has its downsides, I guess.
Being blind also gives you superhuman hearing, you traitorous dog!
You disgusting bastard! Oh no! It's our enemies, Agent Red and Agent Rouge, from the Red Brigade of the Soviet KGB!
America. We wouldn't dare think of that life in our new mid-sized studio apartment in the Bronx.
The rent is really horrible, and since we're unemployed,
we have had to bring you back to Soviet Russia.
Or kill you if we have.
I'd rather do the latter if it matters.
Say that to my face, you coward!
I am!
I've had enough of this. Let's fight!
You'll find my skills have improved since our last fight, friend.
Alright, yeah. Now, I think people might think this was silly.
I like it.
Damn it! She's right. This isn't working for me at all. We need to make this picture better than anything else that has ever been made. What's hip with the kiddies? And no, I am not old.
Young adult novels?
Supernatural creatures falling in love.
Dystopia.
I need to get this on Walking Dead. Season 7 just dropped. It looks so good. Oh, God.
That's it. Zombies. Everyone, take 10. We'll be back with a new direction. Yes.
I can be the hero, I can be your man, I can be the hero.
Oh, Steve, dinner was lovely and the view from the pier is amazing. I think I love you.
Bernice, there's one more thing. Can you marry me?
Regina has grown tired of the sound of her accompanist's poor choice of instrumentation. She is actually playing the piano with her feet. Notice the lack of pedal usage in this segment. She continues playing with virtuosic time, even as she strangles the life out of her bandmate.
Ha ha ha! This is a new musical put together by Sketchers Sketch Comedy Troupe and Singers Theater. It's called Anxiety, the musical. The song's called I Have an 8:30 Every Day This Week.
Yo, what's up? It's your boy Hubert here showing you my thug life. So this is where my hood, where I live, the cul-de-sac where I live and hang out with my homies. And so this is my crib. Yo, let's check it out.
Mom. Yo, ma.
Yo, my crib. It's my crib. Follow me.
So this is my room where I crash at night? Come on, check it out. This is my bed where all the magic happens. Oh, I totally Mario'd your two stone.
My C buttons are taking
it out. I'm gonna C button you.
No.
No, suck it.
Up, up, down, down, left, right, B,
what are you
start.
Doing? What are you doing?
Going on the go, no oh, bitch.
No cheat codes, no cheat.
HBJ, tell about your big fridge.
This is my big fridge. Pretty big, I do big fridge stuff here.
Woo!
Got some mini Oreos, some... Why is there vodka in here? What the...
Get that out of here.
Who put this in here? This isn't mine, this isn't mine. Who put this in here? This isn't mine.
Someone been drinking it.
Fuck. Mom!
Yeah!
You see, every Friday night, my homeboys and I, we play Dungeons and Dragons here for hours and hours, and we one time, we even stayed up past our bedtime!
Hubert!
Yeah, Mom?
Did I just hear the words Dungeons and Dragons? What thug plays Dungeons and Dragons? I put you on this show to make you look cooler and popular. You look like a geek. Now pull down your pants, man. Let your clothes hang out. Yeah, now that's what I'm talking about. And I thought I told you to call yourself Heezy Beezy Jeezy.
That's so stupid.
What did you say?
That's so dope. Tights. Crack-a-lack and booyah.
That's what I thought. Now, do you want girls to notice you?
Yeah.
Well, then you'll do what I say to do. Now let's head to a street corner.
Okay.
And action.
Yo, this is your boy, Heezy Beezy. Jeez. This is the corner where I sell my Yu-Gi-Oh cards and rare holographic Pokemon cards. Like, it's a really holographic rare Charizard card that I sell here, and it's really cool, and it's just like,
Hey, Hubert!
Hey, Grandma.
I'll give you $100, some dentures, and prune juice for that card.
Okay, yeah,
what? Mom, what are you doing? Get out of here! Mom, this is hopeless. You are a whip, a nerd, a geek!
Maybe we should have him fight somebody, you know, toughen him up a bit.
You know, that just might work.
Wait, what?
Hey, Tim, come fight with Heezy over here.
Okay.
Come on.
I mean, is she still on about this? Yeah, let's just get this over
with. Okay. Come on, Heezy, hit him! Hit him! Don't like that! What are they teaching you in Taekwondo? Hit him! Hit him! No,
maybe
hit
we
that.
Should find him a hot girl to flirt with. They always have a tough guy hanging around them, right?
All right. Hey, you!
Me?
Yeah, come hang with my boy here.
Alright, sure.
Come on.
Hey.
Hi.
Well, I guess you're kind of cute.
Hey, what are you doing? I was gonna get you a pumpkin spice latte.
Aw, Trent, you always know how to make my day.
Who is this?
Do you just want to go out for a smoothie?
Hey!
I just feel like there has to be some sort of world beyond the hill, and I just have to explore. Oh, what was that boy? Oh, no, I'm not talking about South Quad. Obviously, nobody gives a shit about South Quad. No, I'm talking about the real world. I just feel like I must have some sort of purpose out there, Coco, and I have to go on a journey of self-discovery in order to find it. Maybe I should sing about it. Do you think I should sing about it, like... Great idea! I love passively hoping my problems will solve themselves. Right. Oh no! The tornado siren! But it's not Wednesday! It's a real tornado! Let's escape! What? Where am I?
You did move.
Oh, cool. I don't think we're in random.
No, you're still in
random. Let me just look at how this strange person is dressed. Who are you?
I'm a guidance counselor here.
Guidance counselor? I think in my realm we call that a fairy godmother. Please, wise fairy godmother, will you please help me find the way to my purpose?
Well, I believe sometimes you have to know where you came from in order to see where you're going. So why don't you go visit the freshman, first year. Over in West Quad.
You mean the place with all the dark clouds looming overhead?
Oh no, that's just Curtis, it's always
like that. How can I get there?
You're on the sidewalk, just walk.
Can I skip?
Well, it's a senior visit day, so I really...
Oh my god!
Is that dog yours? Is it living on campus?
Bye! Oh, hello. Do you know my purpose in life?
Is this some kind of hazing trick? I don't know my purpose in life. I don't even know my major. I don't know anything.
Oh, wow. That's even better than I thought. Who are you?
I'm Sean. I'm a freshman.
Oh, never mind. Compared to you, I at least know a couple of things. Would you like to join me on my journey of self-discovery?
Really? You want to hang out with me?
Sure! I love helping other people. It's like the blind leading the blind. Alright, well maybe we should start at those big science buildings over there. They look like they probably know some stuff.
Okay.
Yes, Sean. You still have 3 more years of dancing. There's still so much for you to learn. It's not that you don't have a brain, it's that you don't know how to use it. The liberal arts education won't be magic.
You're like a wizard.
Oh, no. I'm just a college president. Dr. Tin Man. Are you hunting for human hearts among the student population again? I already told you we stocked up on plenty in the basement of talent.
Oh, really? Thanks.
This is your last strike. This behavior cannot be tolerated very much longer, I guess.
President Weinberg, if you can help me get rid of my stage fright.
What, child? You already overcome your stage fright. In fact, I'm performing a sketch right now. And you, Dora, the way you treated your fellow Dansonian with kindness and respect shows that you have what it takes to stay in academia for a long time. Why don't you stay at Denison and become my protege? And then one day, when I step down, you can take over as president of the college.
Wow, Coco, there really is no place like home.
Symbol 3000 in a row, and now the police are coming!
No, Jesse, you just
won the jackpot of $40 million. Jackhammer Jesse and other Jesse. You know, hey Jesse, ain't it nice to be sitting on the porch? Mm-hmm.
Such a fine day. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Hey, Buds.
Yep.
Are you enjoying my lemonade stand lemonade?
Surprisingly, yes, Jesse. I don't know what you did to it, but it worked out fine.
Thank you. Yes. Use some of the old natural flavoring.
Oh, what is that natural?
Damn it, Jesse! Such a fine day to be at the dentist, huh, folks?
Yeah, well, at least you don't have to get your mouth washed to piss.
I mean, this is what you signed me up for, right?
Mouth washing. It's one of those wisdom teeth operations. They wash your teeth.
No.
Yeah, you can use your little plastic thing to pay for it.
No, you did not, Jesse. I swear to good old Ben.
I don't ready to be put on them.
Get me out of here.
Don't worry, it won't hurt a bit. Just count back from 10.
Oh. Damn, damn it, Chief!
Oh, yeah.
Oh, it's a fine day to be driving, Jesse.
Ha ha ha!